Today we are going to learn about the next bone, new bone, that is humerus. This is the humerus and it is a bone from the arm region. Earlier we have studied a bone, scapula, and it was a bone from shoulder region. The next region is the arm region where the humerus is located. So this is humerus and it's a bone from the arm region. It is placed obliquely downward and backward. Proximally, it is articulated with the glenoid cavity of the scapula to form the shoulder joint, and distally it is articulated with the radius and ulna bone to form the elbow joint. Now we will separate this humerus and we will study it separately. This is the humerus bone, and this humerus bone is a long type of bone, and as you know that all the long bones, they have got a characteristic feature that it has got a body. The part which I am holding is a body part, and these two, they are the ends or the extremities or epiphyses. It means humerus is a long type of bone, presents a body and two extremities. Now we will first start with the body part, and this body part which we have to start, we should first try to name the surfaces of this body.
Wait.
Now to name the surfaces, first we should know certain basic principles. How to hold the humerus?
थोड़ा सा नीचे.
How to hold the humerus? So, the first principle is that the head of the humerus should be held up. Automatically, this condyle part goes downward. While holding, second principle is that we should try to hold this head near to our body. This is wrong. Now this is going away from me. Now this is near to me. So this is the correct position, and when I am holding it like this, now you can see that the part, this one, which is facing towards the head side, so therefore that is called as the cranial surface, which is also otherwise called as the anterior surface. The opposite of this is this surface which is nearer to me, and this surface can be termed as caudal or posterior. Now out of four surfaces, we have named two surfaces, cranial and caudal. But there are two more surfaces, and to name these surfaces, the third principle is there. You should look at the distal part where there are two smooth rounded articular areas which are called as condyles. So one of the condyle is larger, the other condyle is smaller. The larger condyle is always placed on the medial side and lateral on the lateral side, smaller on the lateral side. So larger condyle is on medial side, and therefore this surface we can name it as medial surface. Opposite of medial is lateral surface. So now we have named almost all the four surfaces. This is cranial, this one is caudal, and looking towards the size of the condyle, we can name this as medial surface, and the opposite of medial is lateral, this is lateral surface. Now one by one we will try to study the surfaces. First we'll start with the cranial surface. Look at the cranial surface. Here you will see that it's wide proximally, and as you are going downward, it is becoming narrow. So cranial surface can be described as it is wide proximally and narrow distally. Second surface is caudal surface. This caudal surface is smooth and it is rounded from side to side. The third surface is medial surface. It is straight, and little above its middle, it presents a rough protruded area here. And this is called as teres tubercle. This teres tubercle gives attachment to the teres major muscle, and the second muscle is latissimus dorsi muscle. Now fourth surface, this is the lateral surface. This lateral surface, as if it is twisted and it is spiral and presents a groove. This groove is called as musculospiral groove. So lateral surface is characterized by presence of the musculospiral groove where it lodges the brachialis muscle. Then next is that when you look at the cranial surface, medial surface, there is no exact line of demarcation between these. Similarly, the medial surface and the caudal surface, there also there is no exact line of demarcation. The caudal and lateral surface, there is also no exact line of demarcation. Now look at the lateral surface and cranial surface. Here you will see that the lateral and the cranial surface, they are separated from each other by a crest. This crest is called as crest of humerus, and in the middle of the crest there is rough protruded area that is called as deltoid tuberosity. This deltoid tuberosity gives attachment to the deltoideus muscle. This completes our body part. Now the proximal extremity. The proximal extremity consists of, here there is head. Just below the head there is a constricted part called neck. Apart from these two structures, here cranially you will see there are two rough protruded areas, and these are called as tuberosities. One of the tuberosity is lateral tuberosity, the other is medial tuberosity. In between these two tuberosities there is groove, and that groove is called as bicipital groove or the intertuberal groove. So we will say that the proximal extremity is characterized by presence of head, neck, two tuberosities and an intertuberal groove. Now head, look at the head. How we define it? It is a smooth, circular, articular area. That is called as head. So this head of humerus is smooth, rounded or circular, articular area, and it is very well defined only from the caudal surface. The circumference of the head of humerus is double than the circumference of the glenoid cavity of scapula. Now, just below the head, there is a constricted part which is called as neck. And neck is also well defined only from the caudal surface. This neck joins to the head and the body part. Then, cranially, on either side of the head, there are two rough protruded areas which are termed as tuberosity. Based on their location, they can be named as lateral tuberosity, and lateral tuberosity is larger in size, therefore it is also termed as greater tuberosity. The other tuberosity is smaller, and that tuberosity is on the medial side, and that is called as lesser tuberosity. In between these two tuberosity, there is one groove. Groove means it is a elongated concavity, and this groove is named as intertuberal groove or the bicipital groove, and it is for the passage of one muscle. That muscle name is biceps brachii. This biceps brachii muscle, it originates from the earlier bone, that is scapula. From the tuber scapula it originates, and it is here passing over the bicipital groove of the humerus. Now distal extremity, it is characterized by the presence of two condyles. Then there are two epicondyles, and there are two depressions, one from cranial side, other from caudal surface. Now about the condyles. These two condyles, they are not of the same size. One of the condyles is larger. So that is on the medial side. So medial condyle is larger, and it is also termed as trochlea because there is one pulley-like structure present over it. The lateral tuberosity is lateral condyle is smaller, and it is termed as capitula. Now I'll hold it in its proper orientation. It is like this. So this goes down and this part comes up. So above the condyles, from this side also above the condyle, these structures which are here, they are above the condyle, therefore they are named as epicondyles, and they are also named as lateral epicondyle and the medial epicondyle. Cranially, above the condyles, there is one depression. This depression is called as coronoid fossa or the radial fossa. And caudally, there is a deep depression. This deep depression is called as allegranon fossa, inside which the Amconius process, this is the Amconius process of the ulna, it is projected inside like this. So this is all about the humerus. Now we will see how the humerus can be differentiated, whether it is from the left side or the right side. I have taken one of the humerus which is from the left side, the other is on the from the right side. So if you take this, so as I earlier told you that you should first look look for the presence of the head. So head should be held up and should be held near to you. So these cold eyes, they go away from you. So you should hold it in both the hands first, keeping the head near to you, so that you can name the two surfaces as cranial and caudal. And to name medial and lateral, you have to look at the distal extremity where the condyles are there. The larger condyle is on medial side, therefore I will call this surface as medial and this as lateral. Now again I am holding it in both the hands with the knowledge of all the names of the surfaces: cranial, caudal, medial and lateral. Now in order to bring this particular medial surface on the inside part of the body, and I want that lateral surface should be on the outer side of the body, I will have, suppose I am holding it in this hand. Now here I have called this surface as lateral surface, this as medial, but when I am holding it in this hand, the medial surface is going to the lateral side, it means I am holding it in a wrong way. So I have got two options. I can turn it. The moment I turn it, the first principle fails here, because I told you that the head should be held near to you. Now therefore what I have done is wrong. Again I will bring it to its normal position. So what is the other option? Other option, instead of holding it in this hand, if I transfer this bone into my other hand, and now if I see that the surface is, this cranial is correct, this is caudal, I said that this is medial and I am holding it in this hand. So this coincides with the medial plane of my body and this is going on the lateral side. So I will say that this fits in my right hand, therefore this is the right side humerus. The another, for the purpose of practice, again you can take another humerus, and as I told you, the first principle is hold the head up, should be kept near to you. I am holding it in this way. So these condyles, they are going away from me. So now I can name this surface as cranial, this as caudal. To name the medial and lateral, I told you that you have to look at the condyles. This yellow color part of the condyle, that is on the medial side and it is larger. Therefore this surface becomes medial and opposite of medial becomes lateral, because that is from the smaller condyle side. So cranial, caudal, medial, lateral. Now if I am holding it in this hand, what happens? The medial surface is going away and lateral surface is coming inside. It means it is wrong. So I will just transfer this bone from this hand to the other hand, and I hold it like this. When I hold it, this is cranial, this is caudal. I have termed this surface as medial. This medial coincides with the medial plane and this becomes the lateral. And so I will say that this fits in my left hand, and therefore this humerus is from the left hand. This is how we should identify the left and right bone. Thank you.